This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create an extraterrestrial alien engulfed in a cocoon of light. I provided a Photoshop document so you could follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. It contains three layers, a black base, a translucent orb, and a silhouette figure. In addition, I provided this image of a spacecraft interior, which we'll use as our background near the end of this video. We'll remove the white background behind the figure. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, first make sure the silhouette figure is active, and open your magic wand tool. Click anywhere on the white area to make a selection of it. Press the Delete key to delete the white area. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Notice the white fringe along the edge of the figure. We'll get rid of it by going to Layer, Matting, and Defringe. Make the width 1 pixel and click OK. We'll convert the silhouette figure into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 6 pixels, then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Filter, Other, and Maximum. Make its radius 10 pixels and the preserve roundness. Basically, the maximum filter has the effect of applying a choke, spreading out white areas and choking in black areas. Conversely, the minimum filter has the opposite effect by applying a spread, spreading out black areas and shrinking in white areas. Double-click an empty area of the figure's layer to open its layer style window. I'll drag it over so we can see the figure. Click Outer Glow. If the color box isn't white, click it and pick white. The blend mode is lighten, the opacity is 100%, and the noise is 0. The technique is softer, the spread is 0, and the size is 250 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 100%. Next, we'll stretch the figure vertically to give it an elongated alien shape. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the smart filters will be temporarily turned off as we use the transform tool. Go to the top middle anchor point and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it up approximately this much. We'll compress it a bit horizontally by going to a side anchor point and pressing and holding the same hotkeys as you drag it in, then press Enter or Return. If you want to go back to adjust any of the figure's filters, we can do it since they're smart filters. For example, let's brighten the glow around the figure. Double-click Outer Glow and open the Contour Presets. If you don't see the names of the presets next to their thumbnails, click the gear icon and click Small List. Scroll to Rolling Slope Ascending and click it. To save space in the Layers panel, collapse the smart filters. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and Color Balance. Open the Tone List and click Shadows. Make the cyan red 41. Keep the magenta green 0, and make the yellow blue minus 65. Click Midtones. Make it 5, 10, and minus 100. Click Highlights. Make it 100, minus 100, and minus 100. Next, we'll make the shape of the orb oblong. Make the orb layer active, open your transform tool, and go to a side anchor point. press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in approximately this much. Then press Enter or Return. Drag the orb to the top of the Layers panel and change its blend mode to Screen. Next, we'll remove the orb's milky midtones while keeping the orb's highlights. Double-click the orb to open its layer style window. We'll use the Blend If feature to do this. Basically, Blend If blends images together using the luminosity of its pixels. This layer is the current active layer. In this case, it's the orb itself. By dragging the black triangle to the right, it removes the orb's darker colors, while dragging the white triangle to the left removes its lighter colors. The underlying layer represents all the layers below the orb. By dragging its sliders, it forces the colors from the underlying layers to show through the orb based on their luminosity. For the orb, we'll only be using this layer. Drag the black triangle to the right to remove the darker pixels. We can smooth out its transition by Alt-clicking or Option-clicking the middle of the triangle, which divides it in two. Drag the right half of the triangle to the right, which gradually fades out the pixels between the left half of the black triangle and its right half. Next, we'll colorize the orb and give it a dark reddish outer glow. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. An adjustment layer affects all of the layers below it in the Layers panel, so if we want it to affect just the one layer below it, click the Clipping Mask icon or go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. You could also press Alt-Ctrl-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. Check Colorize. For the hue, type in 30, and for the saturation, type in 100. Double-click the orb to open its layer style window. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Pick a bright red. Change its blend mode to normal and its opacity to 20%. Make the spread 10% and the size 125 pixels. Open the contour list and click Cove Shallow. The range is 100%. Make the figure active and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. We're going to brush a soft white shape over the middle of the orb, so check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Then press X to invert them so white is your foreground color. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft round brush. Make its size 700 pixels, the hardness 0%, its opacity 60%, and its flow 100%. Go to the middle of the orb and click once. Open your Transform tool and go to a side anchor point. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in approximately this much. Go to the top middle anchor point, press the same hotkeys, and drag it up. Then press Enter or Return. This creates a soft white oblong shape. Next, we'll add a soft glow at the feet of our alien. Copy the soft white shape layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. We'll jump the copy down two layers to just below the figure by pressing Ctrl or Command and the left bracket key twice. We'll place it into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Reduce its opacity to 18%. Make the shape in the folder active and open the Transform tool. We'll compress the shape horizontally. Go to the top middle anchor point and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it down approximately this much. Press and hold the Shift key as you drag it down to the feet. Pressing Shift kept it perfectly vertical as you dragged it. I think I'd like to adjust its compression, so I'll go back to the top middle anchor point, press the hotkeys, drag it up, and press Enter or Return. Make a copy of it. We'll make the copy smaller in size. Open back the Transform tool and go to a corner. If you're using a version earlier than CC 2019, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in approximately this much. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll add a lens flare. But before we do, let's save some space in the Layers panel by collapsing the folder. Scroll to the top and make the adjustment layer active. Above it, we'll make a composite snapshot of our visible image so we won't have to guess to position the lens flare. To do this, press Alt-Control-Shift-E on Windows or Option-Command-Shift-E on a Mac. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Tick 35mm prime and make the brightness 100%. Drag the lens flare over the brightest spot on the orb. Now that we have a lens flare in its position, fill the composite snapshot with black by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. We'll add back the lens flare by pressing Alt-Control-F on Windows or Option-Command-F on a Mac. Photoshop applied the last filter we used, keeping its settings and position. Change its blend mode to Screen. The reason we didn't keep the composite snapshot is so we have the ability to go back and change any of the filter settings if we want to. We'll blend in the layers flare more using the Blend If feature that we used for the orb. Double-click the lens flare to open its layer style window. Go to the middle of the black triangle of this layer and Alt-click or Option-click it to split it in two. Drag the right half anywhere between 85 and 90 and drag the left half to 40. Lastly, we'll place our alien image onto the background I provided. Feel free to use another background if you like. To place it into our alien image, press Ctrl or Command A to select it, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Open the alien image, and scroll to the bottom of the Layers panel. Make the black background active. Directly above it, we'll place the new background. Press Ctrl or Command V to paste in the new background. We'll adjust the background's brightness and contrast by clicking the adjustment layer icon and clicking Levels. If your Levels panel is partially hidden, just drag the other panels down. Before we adjust the amounts, keep in mind, since every image has its own characteristics of brightness and contrast, you may want to type in different amounts if you're using a different background. For this particular background, in the output white levels, I'll type in 47. For the input black level, I'll type in 8. And for the input midtones, I'll type in 1.24. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.